Hi, good afternoon. First of all, thank you for giving us this opportunity to represent our works. My name is Sakine Yalman. I am a PhD student at the University of Exeter and my supervisor, Professor Dr. Ahim Brücker. Today, I would like to talk about our work, Secure Life Cycle Assessment in Complex Supply Chain. Supply chain is a set of processes and entities which are interested to fulfill a customer order. And it involves various kinds of companies, such as manufacturers, suppliers, retailers, distributors, and consumers. And the environmental impact of products becomes an increasingly important factor in buying decisions of customers. And it is also an important concern of lawmakers. Therefore, companies have an increased interest in determining the ecological footprint of their products. So, life cycle assessment is a methodology for assessing environmental impact associated with all the stages of the life cycle of a commercial product, process or service. You can see the two examples associated with it. It's showing the carbon footprint of products. So today LCA is not usually computed in real time and neither it is using actual production data. It is computed offline using historic values based on exemplary measurements. But with the rise of Internet of Things, actually LCA can be based on actual production data. So with IoT, we can compute LCA in real time using actual sensor data. So everything sounds good so far. Where is the problem? So while an LCA is based on actual production data is highly desirable from ecological perspective, it can also reveal confidential data about production processes, as well as business relationships between companies in a supply chain. I would like to continue with a simple example to explain traditional life cycle assessments and also our approach. We took this example from International Aluminium Institute. It is published in 2010. As you can see in this diagram, gives us the supply chain of primary aluminium production. And the life cycle of aluminium contains several supplier companies, which provides unit processes such as anode, aluminium, aluminia, and etc., which are interconnected to allow calculations on the complete system in the supply chain. So they did not add additional unit processes such as energy production or transport to avoid non-elementary flows. On the right side, you can see the following calculations for life cycle assessment. With the following calculations, we get inventory vector. It is the vector that it is the final aggregated environmental flow of the whole supply chain. And when we calculate it, we multiply B matrix and S vector. B matrix is the environmental flows matrix represents the flows from and into the environment. And as you can see, each column of that matrix represents each companies of the supply chain. And also scale vector is the vector that contains scale value of each company. And each row in the scale vector represents each company of the supply chain. So this is the general calculation of life cycle assessment. However, there are some security challenges. LCA computation is made by a centralized system. So they are using one big matrix. So it can reveal confidential data of companies that includes market profits and also the data of production process service and business relationships between companies. In addition to it, certificate authorization is provided by a third party company or a main company. So this company can disclose the information of companies. And if it colludes with some outside inside companies, it can share the private information of companies. So you can ask or wonder that why we don't apply privacy enhancing techniques naively directly to the life cycle assessment. The reason is that, as I said before, the computation happens with big matrix sizes. So if we use naively secure privacy enhancing techniques in it, this will make calculation more complex. Also, the system will be terribly slow. So we developed a model for ensuring confidentiality in life cycle assessments. So we make one level aggregations, so local computations, in a recursive way that it ensures the information privacy of companies in the supply chain. So, and we make computations with small matrix sizes, and we are applying security enhanced techniques in this small matrix sizes. In our example, we have a three level of supply chain. And in the first level, we have main company, A company, with its suppliers B and C companies. And in the second level, we have as a main company B and C companies and their suppliers D, E, F companies. And in the third level, we have E companies with its suppliers G company. So in the beginning, our system start from up, down to up, from main company to suppliers. So A company asks to its suppliers to supply the environmental flows, but actually the local LCA flows. So if they don't have, then they are asking their suppliers, supplier companies to supply the environmental flows so they can make one level computation and get the result and send to A company. And like that, we are going from down to up and we are starting to make computation from up to down. So from suppliers to main company. So our first aggregation calculation happens between E and G companies and we get the result. E company gets the result and use this local LCA result as a supplier for rectangle three and rectangle two computations. In the second level, as I said, this is the second level, we can do G2, G3 computations parallelly because they don't depend on each other and they don't relate it to each other. And after that, as you can see, each one has just three companies in it, in the computation. B and C companies get their local LCA results. And then they are using this one, these results in final computation. So rectangle four computation. And it has happened between A, B, C companies. And then A company gets the total result of the total LCA result of whole supply chain. So we transform a global computation into several local computations. So how are we ensuring confidentiality? As I said before, we make sub-computation aggregations. So it prevents companies to learn the relationship between other companies in the supply chain. Also, certificate authorization is provided by the root company of that local company, and it protects from outside attacks. This doesn't mean that outside attacks of the supply chain, it also includes that outside of the that local computation. So these two points about actually protecting the relationships, business relationships of the supply chain. For preventing the disclosure of companies' confidential data in computations, these local computations, we are using secure multi-party computations. So it is a generic cryptographic primitive that enables distributed parties to jointly compute an arbitrary functionality without revealing their own private inputs and outputs data. So why we cannot apply secure multi-party computation into traditional life cycle assessment? As I said before, because of the complexity of formula being computed and the number of companies involved. So with our idea, we made formula more simpler in each level, and we reduced the number of participants involved in one individual computation. So that is our approach scale. Thank you for listening. I'm happy to answer your questions.
Thanks again. Thanks a lot. It was very interesting presentation. Okay, so while you are waiting for question for the attendees, I have actually a few questions about one. We can start with one. So so I was wondering, so maybe it's a stupid question, but I was wondering why you used three levels, or is three levels due to the number of companies that you had an example, and these levels grows up based on the number of companies that you have in the supply chain?
So you are asking why it is three level?
Yeah.
Or actually this is for this example.
So it grows up based on the number of companies that is involved in the...
Yeah,
sure. Okay.
Yeah. For example, in our example, it has just three levels because, for example, in one level, for example, A company is the main company and it has suppliers B and C companies. But A company doesn't need to know who is the D, E, F companies, just B, C companies needs to know the E companies. So we are dividing the levels depending on their relationship in the supply chain.
Okay, so let's say if you have 100 companies involved in the chain, you have 100 levels, let's say.
You mean 100 level or?
Yes, I mean, my question is, let's say, how can you compute the level, let's say, if the levels are linked to the number of companies in the supply chain?
Actually, it's something like, for example, if you produce a car, so it is getting some small units from other companies. So these companies, it's just related to the car company. So this whole has a just one level. And when they, for example, the supplier, let's say tire supplier, has also supplier like plastic or metal. So when they do relationship, so we are considering this relationship as a one level too.
Okay, great. So, okay, thanks a lot. Let's see, is there any other questions? Okay, so I have one last question for you, then we can move on. So in the beginning of the presentation, you talk about performance, and you let's say you introduced this method because of performance problems. So I was wondering if you actually test it, or you plan to test it, and if you have some preliminary results you can share with us.
Actually, now we are in the evaluating our approach. Normally, life cycle assessment has big matrix, so it is actually working like a quadratic. And if you add some also secure multi-party computation, you know that it's workload. So we are doing small matrix sizes. We are assuming that we didn't get our result yet, but we are guessing that our approach will work more like n log n. So actually the main thing in our approach that we can provide scalability.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, perfect. Thanks a lot. Just the very last question, then you can go. Do you have any idea how big these matrices can be? Like, I mean, under the elements, or just to have an idea, just out of my curiosity.
Actually, it depends on the economic flows and environmental flows.
Yeah, sure.
Actually, economic flows related to actually business relationship between companies. So actually the number of participants involved. And so we are reducing that part. For environmental flows part, it depends on the companies that which environmental flows they want to involve in this computation. So for example, it can be changed in each level. So they can want to learn different flows.
Okay. Okay. So thanks.
Yeah.
Thanks a lot. It was super interesting. So thanks a lot, Sakin, again.